Hi, it's Claire from Cluesy. Thank you so much for tuning into my frequency today. So I just wanted to quickly touch on sugar versus artificial sweeteners, and is it a wise idea to cut sugar completely from your diet? So there's a couple of things. So I'm a big believer in the body needs sugar. The brain uses about 120 grams of sugar a day just for basic functioning. The liver uses a lot of sugar as well. Yes, it converts things to sugar, but it also requires sugar to function. The body itself, like your bloods contain sugar, so you know, it's our fuel source. But you can get really good sugars from fruits, from food. You don't need to go out to the local sugarcane farmer, which, you know, I live in North Queensland. Well, I live in Southeast Queensland. We still have sugarcane farmers here. But if you're a North Queenslander, you know, you don't have to run out and suck on the sugarcane. But it's probably best if you wanted to have sugar that way, it would be the best way. Because refined sugar, so the sugar that you get in the little packets at your cafe or, you know, that's sitting in the cupboard, that refined sugar goes through so many processes to just become sugar. So not only is I'm gonna read you some of the chemicals that they use in the production of your white refined sugar that you get at the cafe or in the supermarket or whatever. Sulfur dioxide. So sulfur dioxide turns it white. It has, it's a chemical that is, when it's released by factories using fossil fuels, it combines with the atmosphere and causes acid rain. And you're eating that. Phosphoric acid, it's another chemical used. It's been linked to tooth decay. It's like basically a battery acid to your teeth. Also known as a skin and respiratory irritant. Calcium hydroxide, they use this to purify the sugar before it's evaporated into the crystals. This can cause vision loss, severe throat pain, severe skin and eye irritation, bloody stools, vomiting, low blood pressure, organ damage, breathing difficulties, and tissue necrosis, which means death of the tissue. So raw cane sugar is less processed than the table sugar and doesn't contain that. So that's an interesting thing. What, I don't believe this stuff is actually on sale in the shops. It just horrifies me. I haven't finished though. Then there's polyacrylamides or something like that, which is a new thing that they've started using. It's a known neurotoxin. So what does that mean? It means it's toxic to your nervous system. Now, if you've listened to any of my videos in the year I've been making these videos, you'll know that the nervous system is the third most important system in your body, other than your emotions, which is kind of your nervous system in a way, and the lymphatic system. But without nerves, nothing works. And this stuff is toxic. Can also cause incontinence, speech disorders, nausea, sweating, blah, blah, blah. So if you've ever given up sugar, now you'll know why you feel better, because you've given up a hell of a lot of chemicals at the same time. So that's a reason why never to eat white sugar. I'm not a fan of processed sugars like that. I don't have a sweet tooth. I never have. Instead of using these kind of sugars, you can use honey. And I'm not talking about Capilano honey from the supermarket, because it comes from China. And guess what? It isn't honey. They feed the bees sugar syrup, and the bees convert the sugar syrup to honey. So basically you're just having sugar syrup. It's not like you go to your local apiarist, beekeeper, and they've got, you know, they're taking the trays out of the hive, and it's pure honey coming from the bees that have been eating pollen from flowers. Like that honey, that's the kind of honey I'm talking about. Honey, get that kind of honey. There's lots of people, and I know in the major cities now, they've got, you know, rooftop beehives and stuff like that. So if you're going to use honey as a sweetener, you need to get real honey. Just do your research. It's really easy. Google tells you everything just about these days. You can find out what companies are doing what. It's just a matter of, you know, just being a little bit more conscious about what you're putting into your body. So fruit, so bananas are really high in sugar. Strawberries taste really sweet. So that can, if you've got a sweet tooth and you want to get off the sugar, have a punnet of strawberries. There's very minimal calories in strawberries, but they're super, super sweet and they're delicious. And if you're like me and you live on the Sunshine Coast, there are strawberries everywhere. And they are delicious. But make sure they're organic, because they take up a lot of pesticides. You can't win, can you? No, you can't. What else? So, you know, sugars aren't bad, but refined white sugar is really bad. Sugar cane sugar is not so good. Sugar beet, you got a lot of nutritional companies that make these shakes. They say, oh, we don't have refined sugar, we use beets. So everybody assumes, oh, it's beetroot sugar. Well, it's not beetroot sugar. There is actually a thing called a sugar beet. So it looks like a baby turnip. That has the exact chemical compound as cane sugar, and it's processed exactly the same way. So when you think that you're having your beet sugar, then you actually might as well just be having sugar cane. It's full of chemicals, it's highly, highly, highly processed, and it's the same chemical compound anyway. So you know what? You are actually having sugar cane sugar. So don't be fooled. Artificial sweeteners, well, I don't even know where to start. You know, if I had a choice, if I was on a deserted island and the only choice I had between death and sugar and artificial sweetener, I'd have the sugar. I wouldn't choose death, and I certainly wouldn't do artificial sweeteners, because your body doesn't recognize it. Your body will recognize sugar, because you know it's got a lot of sugar anyway, so it goes, oh yeah, there's sugar. And if it's too much sugar, then you know your body produces insulin. But if you're having way too much sugar, then the liver gets overwhelmed and it turns things to fat and it stores it in your body, and then you put on weight, blah 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 blah. But with refined sugars, they're synthetic chemicals that bypass your body's immune system. So, you know, these people thinking they're doing the right thing, drinking these diet this and diet that, are actually, and there is study after study after study coming out now about how horrific things like aspartame and NutraSweet and all that, how bad they are for the body. So, you know, when people say, oh, I got this thing and I don't know why. Well, look at what you've been eating for the last 20 years, because you are what you eat. It's like putting diesel into a unleaded vehicle. The vehicle's going to stop working eventually, if not straight away. So you just be really smart about it. And, you know, ingesting chemicals is not a good thing. It's not. They're not. Chemicals are used in, yeah, just... do your homework. I get quite passionate, so I don't mean to belittle anyone or tell you you're doing the wrong thing, but just be a little bit smarter. If you're going to have sugars, have them in the fruit sugars. If you have a sweet tooth, well then eat sweeter fruits and vegetables. Like, I don't know if you've ever had a roast pumpkin that's been slow roasted. It tastes like honey. It really does. There's so much sugar in a pumpkin. So just eat it with your fruit and veggies, and you know, try not to eat your cakes and all of that kind of stuff. But you know, if you are, don't have artificial sweeteners. Have brown sugar over white sugar, but best of all, have fruit sugars over any other sugar. But make sure you have the whole fruit, so then you get the goodness that's in the skin and the flesh and all of that, not just the fructose from the fruit. Anyway, that's enough ranting from me. This has been a very long video, but I'm very, very passionate about this. Your body needs sugar, but you just need to put the right sugar in. All right. Thanks very much again for tuning into my frequency, and I will catch you on the flip side. Bye.